Now, if you've watched this show before, you know these are colors I am, you know, I'm not Miss Pink Person. Okay, here comes a good one. I think unexpected in the shadows. I like to put unexpected things everywhere. I don't know, you ever remember being a kid and playing with the shadows on the wall and doing little birds? And hey, welcome to Give Your Wall Some Soul. I'm Shannon Grissom. Well, I decided to really push it today. Gonna do a self-portrait. And to be a little bit on the safe side, instead of imposing color, I thought we would, I took a great color photograph and made a sepia tone out of it and decided that's what I'd work with. So this one's all about values and shape and form. And that way we won't worry about color at all. I love the photo. This is something that was taken by my friend Richard Swan. And like my sister says, if you got Richard, you don't need a facelift. And you don't need any surgery, you're good like it is. So, but there are a few wrinkles showing in the picture, and that's what I look like, so that's what I'm gonna paint. The thing I like about self-portraits is it gives you a chance to check in with yourself as you're painting them, because there's all kinds of stuff will come up. So this ought to be an interesting ride. Well, where am I going to start? Well, for me, if I were home in the studio, I'd start any number of places. Since we're on TV, I'm going to start with the eyes. I'm going to start with the things that I need to be a little bit careful about in the beginning. And then as the show goes further down the road and I forget to be careful, then I won't have to worry about whatever I'm creating. So how's that for logic on where to start? All right. Normally what I would do is create values. I'd make a dark, medium, and light. And I thought about just getting a brown and a white and doing it that way, but it would be too pink. So we're actually going to use black, quinacridone, and this is a quinacridone scarlet, interesting brown. It is on the red side. It has to be, and you know the whites would be just a little too cold, and I couldn't do a cool painting, so I'm using a little bit of the cad yellow deep and some white. Now the pupils, I'm going to use some straight black. I'm not even going to mix anything there, and that's like the darkest spot. So I'm going to put those in first, and once we get the pupils in, I'll start mixing some color. So I'm going to use a little bit of medium, wipe that off. That might even be too much already. I'm going to go straight into the black, and just, I've already sketched this out. I wanted this to be more a lesson in form. So I'm just going to quick put in these little pupils. One here. And one on the other side. When I paint portraits and eyes, I like to do one and then the other, one and then the other. It really helps keep things consistent. These are some little odd little shapes. There we go. That's a good start for now. Okay, we have two dots on the canvas. We can start now. All right, so what am I gonna do? Let's mix some color here first. So what do I want? Four values, maybe five? So we have black as our dark. Only for the most part, I'm gonna add, it's just a little too cold, so I'm adding some nice sepia to it. I gotta warm it up a little. Ooh, see, I love that stuff that happens on the palette underneath. Okay, so there's a nice dark. like that. And then a medium. I'll grab a bunch of this. Just a little bit of, see, this is very transparent. So you've got the black that's an opaque color, and the quinacridone is very transparent. So I'm going to add a little white to this to give it some body. My concern is it'll get a little pinky on me, so I'm going to have to add some. Oh, that's pretty. Got to warm it up a little. A little bit of this. There we go. That's good. And then a medium light. And these piles are way too small, but they're a good start. So I'll grab some light. Now, if I put this just here, it's going to be cold, 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 and pink. Ooh. Ooh, I kind of like that. Changed my mind. I wasn't going to go there, but ooh, that's awesome. I will use that. Those are good lip color. That actually looks like lipstick that I have. I actually have some that's not red. Okay, I'm going to set that aside. That's cool. That's not what I was looking for, but that's cool. I'll move some of this over. Got to warm it up. Looks like what I just made, but we're going to tone it down with a little black. Ouch. May use that. So I'm mixing the sepia tones here, and I'm not liking what I see. And I could make all of these tones and add a little more yellow and try to fix it that way. Or, and I didn't bring extra paint. So this is what I decided to do. I don't have any extra pigment, so I can either play with this and make what I want, or I can do something in just black and white. So I'm going to mix a few more colors and then decide. So this is as much a learning experience for me as it is for you guys. Okay, that's actually a nice transition. Sometimes you get lucky. Okay, those are harmonious. A little lighter tone here. I'm just going to pull a little bit of this over, warm it up a little. Now I could do this as just a value study, or after it dries, I can go back into it and put color over the top. I've gone both ways. Okay, so that's a nice light. There needs to be something in between that, but that's all right. And then I'm going to add a pure, just a little bit of this, just a dab of that. Oh, that's pretty. Add some more of this. I'm just going to grab this whole pile. There we go. And I need to make it a little pinker, just a little bit. So I'm just going to grab a little of that. Now they're in the same family. Okay, that works. It's still a lot cooler than I would do. I am dying for some red hair. But I think this is a great, great start. Okay, so what's dark, what's medium, what's light? Where do you go with this thing? I've cropped it so that this is really dark in here. I can quickly put that in. And it's a mid-tone there. And that'll, you know, start to make things pop. But like I said, I really need to be careful in the beginning because I really do, you know, once I get started, you guys know what happens. I just lose it. So let's... Where do I want to start? I'm going back to the eyes. I'm going to get the darkest dark for the eyelashes and kind of sketch that in. I think I put too much medium on this, way too much medium on this. So I'm going to wipe it off. Okay. So let's sketch in the eyes. It's really interesting to be able to detach from something when it's your own self. Roughly, I'm going across the tops now. They're darker up here. I'm gonna add a little black to that, but not totally dark. Where else? It's darker right here. Kind of weird to give myself brown eyes. Okay, and then I'm going to go just around the edge. Now, if I were to use that same and outline it, I'd look really funny. So I'm not going to do that. I'm going to go get a lighter brown because the value is a little bit lighter here. And just see what I can do around this area here. And before I lose it, because once you start blending, the white goes away, I'm going to get a small brush and put in the white. I'm not going to use any medium here either. It needs to be thicker for when I forget. See, when you know that you're prone to do things, you don't have to change how you do them. You just need to kind of work around how you are. It's a lot easier that way than trying to fix yourself. Okay, so there's light there. Nothing's showing up yet because it's just still too early. Now I'm going to do a lighter tone for the eyeballs. So what value is that? I've got this really cool device that I'm going to stick here on the palette. Let's see if I can just stick it right here so that you can see it. And it's a value scale, so it shows from light to dark how, you know, where you should be when you're mixing your color. So it's awesome to be able to tell you whether you've got the right value or not. So you can check that against your reference photo or even in real life and see how on target you are. Okay, so I'm going to mix the thing about eyeballs, lots of things about eyeballs, but... they're round. So a lot of people will just do the same color all around, you know, one solid color, and it has no form. But they are round things in these sockets, so we're going to give them all that form. All right, so the edges, my other little tiny brush. These are the tiniest brushes I'd ever used. Okay. Okay, so I'm going to make this a little dark around the edges, here and here. Darker here. And then we need a little medium tone. I don't think that's light enough. I'm going to wipe my brush off, use a dirty brush, Had a little bit of this late. I needed something in between. That's better. So this little part here seems a little tedious, and it might be just the initial part, but it's going to get wild later. And I'm just going up to the edge and not, and you know, just barely touching it. So there's lots of different ways you can have somebody take a picture of you, or you can take a picture of yourself. You can do it in a mirror, which is fun. Mirror is a really good way to do it because it's that really stretches you. But there was no way I was going to do it in a mirror on TV because it's enough pressure doing it anyway, let alone doing it in a mirror. Okay. A little bit lighter in the middle. I think if this were warmer, I can already tell you what I'm going to do with it. If this were warmer, a little more red in it, I might leave it just as a value study, but I'll bet you we may have a two-parter where I come back and put color over the top. We'll see. A little too early to tell. Okay, we got eyeballs starting to come out. All right, so let's get the inside of that done. And it's not just white, more of a fleshy color. A little bit right here, so it's darker.